Hello everybody, it's Eva from Behavior Crafting here again. Welcome to my channel. Thank you for visiting me today. I've got here three journals. They are different theme, but all of them are made that based from all of them. It's made out of file folders, and today I would like to show you how I made it. It's very easy. And I will also show you three different types of binding those folders. So very quickly, I think I will show you these journals in separate video, but very quickly I will show you what I mean with those file folders. This is steampunk, kind of steampunk, and these file folders are used like base for my papers and base for pockets and all kind of openings and secret pockets and everything. So for this I used file folders, and in this journal I made mistake, so I'm gonna explain you what I made, which mistake I made, and also how I repaired that mistake. Then maybe you can use it in your journals, or maybe you can use it in photo albums you will make if you will make same mistake. So I'm gonna put all these journals on the side, and sorry for my voice. In last video I told you that probably some winter laziness is coming on me, but it was flu, and it got me to my bed for more than a week. I wasn't able even move. That was horrible. And I'm trying to take this video third time now. For three times I tried to do it before, but I think I wasn't ready yet. My brain wasn't ready. So we already made together, not together, but I tried to explain how to do it. So you've got here a bunch of file folders. Also, I showed you, not really, but it was trying how you can make your old template. So I'm gonna show you this one as well, but today I chose only simple book page, and I chose Aladdin because it will be kind of miracle if I will finish this video. So for these journals, and I will try to show you as much as I can from those journals as well, I used simple file folder, this type of file folder. It's very simple one. It's just large piece of paper, half. One side it's a little bit shorter, other side it's a little bit bigger. All these journals are similar tall. Even it doesn't look that way, but all these journals has base 8 inches tall, those file folders. It's just those two covers are a little bit bigger than this one. This is actually 8 inches tall. These are a little bit bigger than those papers inside. So I'm gonna show you what I made with that file folder. And as you can see, I'm using file folder in kind of dark yellow, if I can say, color. And because I don't like this color, I had to distress all these edges. So I'm gonna explain you how I did it very fast. So I took that file folder, and because I wanted to have 8 inches tall, sorry, 8 inches tall journal, I put that file folder to my trimmer on 8 inches, and I cut that end out. This we will save for binding. Then this shorter side I placed here, and it's nearly 9 inches. It's end up exactly before 9 inches. So I placed that middle score line, I placed on a 9 inch score line. I'm sorry for my voice. I'm still not proper, not alive. I am alive. And I scored my my file folder in 4.5 inches. Then I turn it over. Again, I put that middle score line on 9 inches. Not, oh, what I did. Just bear with me. I'm gonna check it out if I didn't make mistake right now. Because I'm laughing and I'm not paying attention. Yes, good. Again, 9 inches. And again, score on 4.5. It was middle of this page. And I'm gonna show you why I did it. Now, fold it this way. And fold it this way. And when you turn it over, you've got like cascade of your pages, which give you huge possibility to create those beautiful tabs, and they will be like cascade, so you can see all of them. And because I made here just one line, that was that mistake I made in this journal. I made only one line here. Then I distressed all these edges, and because it's kind of huge amount of distressing, all these edges here, all this one, I wanted to distress or color to black color, because I wanted to have that in this grungy style. And if I will take a distressing ink, it will take forever to do it. So what I made, this is old old ink pad. It was proper dry. I didn't have any ink inside. So I bought this printer. It's black printer color. It cost, I think, £1.50. Oops. Oh, sorry for my hands. It's leaking probably. I bought this printer color. And I put that printer color into that ink pad. And I have to say that it's inking very fast all these edges. That ink, because it's printer ink, it dries so fast, and it was much more easy to do it with this ink than if I will try to take some distress ink. It will take me forever. So, and it's cheap, it's really cheap. I've got still loads of inside. So, and now I'm gonna show you. I scored this file folder just with one line, then I distress it, and I embellished all my beautiful pages. And this should be like middle page. This should be glued together. And when you embellish all your pockets and layouts, it makes this this pocket very sturdy, very heavy. For this journal, I made binding like is used in photo albums. And that binding I made from piece we cut out. From this piece, I'm gonna show you which binding I made. This is 8 inch tall, so from that rest we cut out. I cut piece a little bit shorter than is 8 inch. I cut out piece 7 7/8, and then I made. I prepared my binding. I think it's called hinges, something like this. And I start with 1/2 inch score line, which should be, when you will look to the cover, this is cover, back cover, front cover. So that 1/2 inch here, it's this line here, that line which is going from back cover to your pages. And then I scored, I wanted to have inside of my pages, where my pages will be glued on it, I wanted to have inside that hinge 1/2 inch. So I scored 1/2 inch and 1/2 inch, because you will have to fold it together and glue those two 1/2 inches together, and it makes actually that hinge for your page. Here you will later glue your pages like this. And here it's that problem what I made. When I embellished my page and I wanted to glue it down, I found out that if I will glue it down like this, and because my page is over-embellished and there is a lot of going on, there is so many pockets and magnets and ephemeras and everything, it was kind of like this in that book, and I couldn't move it even on any side. So what I made from that other piece, which we have here left, I cut again those 7 7/8 piece, and then I cut 1/2 inch, I think it was 1/2 inch, no, it was 1 inch strips, 1 inch wide strips, loads of them, because I need 2 strips, 1 inch strips, like this, for every single middle, for every single middle page, which will be glued on the bottom, and which I wanted to glue to my hinge binding. I cut 2 pieces similar tall, like is my binding hinges, and 1 inch wide. Then I glued those pieces, one here, and I glued I think 1/4 inch inside to my page here, and that on that other side as well, here again 1/4 inch, and then I glued with those hinges, with those extensions to my hinges, and that's why I can open, beautifully open my pages. It's laying down. I can show you. Here you can see that extension. Here you can see that it's that extension. I decorated with washi tape. Here I decorated with lace to make it pretty. But because I made this extension for my pages, I don't struggle with laying down those pages. They are not staring to the air. They are not hard to move. And it's much more easy to work with this book. Even it's loaded, it's those pockets are very hard, very strong, not hard, very strong. So this is one type of binding I used in this book. Those hinges and that extension, and you can use it even in other, not just in journals, in photo books. I believe it will be good, because we embellished our pages so much. We like to do it, right? So it's good to know how you can make your pages movable. So this extension, just piece 1 inch wide and similar tall like are your hinges, it will be good, I think. And now I'm gonna show you another binding I used in this book. This is very colorful book with loads of pockets, with loads of colors, with loads of dyes. And in this book I used again this those hinges. But scoring for this book was a little bit different, and I'm gonna show you. Scoring for this book was, when I placed that shorter side to 9 inches in width, middle line, I scored 4.5 here, and then I scored 4 1/4. I made this 1/4 gap here. Then I turn it. Again, that middle score line I put to that 9. Oops. 9 inches. And again, I scored 4.5 and 4 1/4. Again, I made that 1/4 gap. Then I folded both lines. Like this. And by the way, I said something what is nonsense. I'm sorry. I'm taking back what I said about binding system in this journal. Just bear with me, bear with me. With this book, I didn't make this hinges. No, no. Because I made this 1/4 inch on both sides. When I decorate my pages with all tabs, with all pockets, I glued this pocket here and here. I glue it together and I let it dry properly. And I've got here, I think, two middle pockets. And as you can see, two middle pockets. I glued because it makes here beautiful flat space. I cut piece of decorative paper. This is, by the way, Graphic 45. I think it's that Parisian cafe collection. Those beautiful papers. It's really gorgeous color and it's matching all my ephemeras. So I use it here. Those graphic Parisian, yeah, Parisian coffee. So I cut piece, it's from here to here, piece of decorative paper. I glued my pages on that paper and I let it dry. And because all those pages are fully decorated and there is a lot of ephemeras and everything, to make possible to open this journal properly and make it, it's not flat, but you can open your pages and you can even, you know, open that journal properly. It's just that embellishment, it's too much, but you can open it. And it's just because I didn't glue this middle section to my spine. I glued only those two sides to front cover and to back cover. This moving, it's given to your book that opportunity to open flat, to make possible to write down and do not be struggle with opening like this and you have to press your hand inside. So it's just because here it's that gap and it's giving to those pages that moving, that flexibility. I think it's that right word. If not, I'm so sorry. But it's binding, which I used here in this book. Just glued this middle pocket together. Then cut piece big enough to cover half of front cover, half of back cover, include your spine. Glued your pages in middle of your paper and then glue. When I'm gluing this, I'm always placing my papers with that paper inside of cover. I'm kind of make, you know, that folding, so then I know where I should place glue, because sometimes that book, it works itself, you know. Even we've got all measurement. So then glue just front and back cover to your binding. And with this last book, what I made, this is in Nature Style. And here I made totally different binding. Here I've got exchangeable. I think it's exchangeable. I can take off this notebook and change it for another one. In the middle of this book are these rubber bands for holding my journal. This is just insert, and here are my folders. These are glued, and also first I glued these folders into my cover. How you will do it? You need to fully decorate all your pages and you need to make your journal. Then place it all together on your table. Like if this will be my decorated pages, where I've got something else. All this will be decorated. It will be my pages for my journal, including that insert. I will place it on my table. I'm sorry. I will place it on my table and with my ruler. I will take my ruler and with my ruler I will measure like this how big spine I need for my cover. Then I will make cover, front cover plus spine plus back cover. I will make my cover. Then I will make marks in middle of that cover. Like this is cover for my book. This is cover for my book. I will take my ruler. I will make mark in middle of that cover. There, in exactly of middle of this cover, are those elastic bands. Then you need to measure how much it's one of your folder, including that embellishment. I mean, how much it's this one. This is one side, and this is that other side. So then you will need to measure how much is this fully decorated. Oh, sorry, is this fully decorated? And I made small marks. I measured that for my journal. I will need 1 centimeter. So I made small lines around that middle. I'm gonna show you. Here I made mark that this is middle of my cover. It means that here I will have eyelet, and here I will have eyelet for my insert. Then I made marks that my insert is thick 1 centimeter. So I placed my ruler. Here is 1 centimeter. So in half of centimeter, I place it in middle, and I made here and here it start and end my insert. Then I remembered that inserts which I wanna glued and then sewn to my cover have 1 centimeter as well. So I took my ruler and I made another marks. I made small gap between space for my this insert. So I made, I think, just few millimeters, just small gap between. And then I made mark here and here for my this folder insert. Also on that other side, because I wanted to have one here and another here. Similar way I made it on the bottom. Then I took my embellished and fully decorated inserts and I glued them to those marks. First I glued them and I let it dry properly. And I'm gonna show you these. I used that cross stitch because even in my inserts are papers for writing. So I used cross stitch to sew these papers inside. After all these decorative pages was already glued to my cover. So first I let it dry properly because it can fell off if you will don't let it dry. You know, when you manage that sewing, it can unglued all these pages because they are very heavy. They are fully decorated and it's loads of embellishments and everything inside, and they are kind of heavy. So be sure before you will sew your papers inside, make sure that your folders are glued and dry properly. And then you can sew your papers inside. Then you can put your eyelet, and you've got space for extra insert, and you've got your file folders, including a few pages and including all those ephemeras. So this way I made this journal, all these journals. And also few of you asked me in the past how I made my template for these file folders, because I don't have that beautiful envelope punch. If you've got that envelope punch, use it for your tabs and for all these beautiful endings of your file folders like this. But I don't have it. I've got few of my handmade templates. And when I try to take this video, I try to explain you how you can make it yourself, and also how you can laminate it without laminator. So I'm gonna show you because I already prepared the book page. So I'm gonna show you how you can make it. Take some decorative paper or pizza box, because what I got here for myself, if I will find it, I've got many with different sizes, like this. It's from pizza box. That other side I decorated with some old book page. Here I've got template for different styles or different wideness. Here I've got another one like this. It's very easy to make from pizza box. Yesterday I showed you how you can do it from decorative paper. I took 200 grammage scrap of my papers and I showed you how you can make it. So today I'm gonna take book page, because I think with that laminating pouches, it will be good even from book pages. And believe me, I'm using very cheap from Poundland or Poundworth, very cheap laminating pouches like this, and I don't have laminator. So I can show you how you can laminate your pieces, because it looks good and it will last forever. So take some scrap of your paper and make two lines with 1 centimeter or half an inch between them. So here this book page has 18 centimeters, so I'm gonna make it in middle. It's 9. And that other line I'm gonna make in 8 centimeters. Again, here on the bottom, 9 and 8 centimeters. Draw your line. Here. Here. If you are good in drawing, you can actually draw just without any measurement some tabs like this. Here I will want to have small tab like this. And if you are sure that your tab will be good, just draw it yourself. If you are not sure, take your ruler and make points. I'm gonna do it from this side. You can see that here. I'm gonna make small point here on 2 centimeters, and because it's 1 centimeter gap here between those two lines, I'm gonna make, here is 2 centimeters point, so I'm gonna make 2.5, because that half centimeter is good enough. And I'm gonna like put these two lines together like this. And again, I'm going back to this. I want to have tap, I don't know how large. Here is 2 centimeters. So here I'm going to make in 10 centimeters. Small dot. And here, because that tap, it's on one side, it's shorter. On that other side, it's longer. So here we make 2 and 2.5. Which means here will be 10, but here will be not 10.5, it will be that less, half less. It, which means it will be 9.5 dot. And draw line between those two points. And it will give you beautiful tap, which should be similar on both sides. Now, what you have to do, you have to take your iron and preheat it on cotton on that the highest temperature on your iron, on that highest, because laminator, it works with 300 Fahrenheit degrees, which is I think 150 or nearly 150 Celsius. And I think cotton has 120, if I remember that right. I just think. I'm not sure. But preheat your iron for that highest temperature on your iron. Oops. Take that laminating pouch. Find where is... Ah, Aha. Find where you can place your book page or your decorative paper inside, like this. Find some old t-shirt, old duet cover, old cotton bag, and place your pouch. If I'm saying that wrong, I hope you understand. Place it inside and wait until your iron will be heat enough. So I hope my iron is hot enough. We've got our pouch with that book page with our drawing inside. And now, sorry, I just hit that cable. Now I did counting on every single piece. I counted Mississippi. And then I moved a little bit down Mississippi. Then I moved a little bit down Mississippi. And I pressed firmly to my iron. So do it this way. Count that Mississippi counting. I hear that and I'm watching Friends. You know, I'm learning English from Friends. And because, as you can see my book page through to this fabric. Which means I've got very thin fabric. If you will have a thicker fabric, I believe you will have to turn it over and probably iron it from this side as well. I'm gonna do it here just fast. Because if you will overheat that laminating pouch, it will be curly. It will make those waves. I hope I didn't make any waves. Just a little bit. I think I overheated a little bit as well. But as you can see, we've got laminated or book page. Now you will need to take your scissors and cut. I'm gonna show you how you will cut. Remember your tabs. Go around your tabs. Here I've got one this way. So I'm going this way. And nicely make sure you are going straight on your lines because it will help you later to position your template. Make sure you've got it straight. And here I made a mistake. Like this. Here I made a mistake. Okay, I'm gonna leave it like this. Because if I will cut this tab as well, it will make this very long. I will have to cut this all this line to the end and it will be nonsense. So I'm gonna leave this uncut. Just make sure you draw it right. Here we've got this one. I'm gonna cut all around and make my own template from board. And I am back with our score page. And now what you need to do with your template or with your envelope punch. Make tabs on ends of your folders. And it depends where you want to have that tab. You have to move your template. So here I want to have that tab exactly on the end. With small gap from the end. And what I said, make sure you're going to cut it straight with your lines, because then it's very easy to position your tab with this end and then just draw this line and here this line. You've got your template here and then just cut it with your scissors. If you like not straight corners, if you like very soft, curly corners. Mamma mia. Oh my. Just cut it with your scissors. Like this. And it will show up here. Exactly similar way. You can make it here. Because here we've got tab here. Here I will probably make it here on this other side. Or somewhere in the middle. Because then when it will shown, you can position your tab like this. Here is end of my page. Here it's end of my page. So if I'm positioning this template. I can make it in the middle and draw line here, line here, and then just flip it over because this is laminated. It's very strong, like a ruler. Just end that line and then cut it around. And you will have two tabs very fast. And they are similar. And oops, you can have this template forever. So this way I made my journals, base for my journals, and then I just decorated them a different way, and also I did binding different way. So you've got here these two tabs. This will be middle, middle pocket, large middle pocket. I will probably use that corner punch to make them beautiful, to compare them with those tabs. And now I'm gonna quickly show you, I think, this grungy journal, because I like grungy the most. So this is my grungy journal. Here, when you open it, we've got a picture frame. On this page, we've got here is pocket, also behind this pocket, and I have to place there some tag, I forgot. Here is pocket, and also here is pocket. It can be used like writing space. And I believe, yeah, here is pocket as well. So I have to put there a few more pockets, some embellishments or ephemeras. Here we've got one large pocket, this beautiful tag. And I used in this journal, I used again Vectoria Design images. These are from those steampunk tags. I will try to find this collection, but I've got this collection for a very long time in my computer, so I'm not sure if I will find it. Here we've got another page, again tags, or embellishment or ephemeras. It's in this pocket. Here I used embossing powder to emboss this beautiful stamp of globe. Here we've got pocket. When you open it in this journal, I have a very small book where are some ideas for writing. If you don't have any idea what you will write down, but you wanna maybe practicing your handwriting, here are few ideas. It's few more book pages from this small book with those ideas. Some of them are very funny. Here I've got, this is magnetic holder, and it can hold some tag or embellishment, and also it's holding this pocket with the stack. Open. It's here, and here we've got, this can be open, some photography can be placed here, or some message to use that chalkboard pen. And here is pocket, and as you can see, all these tags have steampunk theme. Here I've got some journaling pages with some ideas what to write down, and I used a few washi tapes. Here we've got another like picture window. Here can be put some picture, and it closes with this. Here is pocket with this. This is just embellishment. Here is here is large pocket, and this picture can be take off, and some another picture can be put inside of this frame, and it's this cabinet card. All my journals has some cabinet cards. I'm trying to put them. Here is some bank check, and this ephemera. Again, some journaling pages, again with some print. Like here is today, and you can write down what you did or what you plan. Here we've got again another pocket frame. This is another cabinet card. Go there, lady. This can be open like this, and it's writing space here. And again, another book page from that small book with some ideas what to write down. And some of them are really funny. I think I will don't even write down what they want. And here is another beautiful paper from Victoria Designs. This paper I've got in my stuff for a very long time as well. And here we've got another opening pocket. Here is pocket. Behind that is another pocket. No, sorry. Behind that, it's not another pocket. Behind that, it's writing space. With this beautiful space, maybe for a picture. I don't even remember what I made. Here we've got this cabinet card. And here we've got, oh, I so love this picture, look at that. I have to place it here. It's that embossed acetate piece, so I make it like pocket. There are two small tags there. And here is another pocket, just with scrap of papers. Here I use Tim Holtz stamp, and this one is from my country. It's like logo of government in Prague. Here we've got this ephemera behind this pocket, and here you can open this one and it's writing space, and behind that it's small pocket. Go there, like this. It's here when you open it. Here is another opening, this is another pocket with writing space, and here is pocket for this tag, and it's closed with this one. When you open it, you've got beautiful space here for writing. It's extended that grid paper. Here another book pages with some writing ideas. Here we've got opening like this for some picture. Here is tag, embossed tag, and another embossed tag. Oh no, this I can't take off because I glue it down. So it's just like embellishment with those Tim Holtz embossing folder effect. And here I've got, I did play. We've got writing space behind this picture. Here, it's writing space. And I used embossing folder for that bingo card, like my background. Here we've got this beautiful steampunk image. And it's many tutorials how you can make this one. It's actually a tutorial for birthday card, for moving birthday card. I will try to find some tutorial for this one, but I don't remember name of that card. So hopefully I will find it. When you turn it over, here I made it's like magnetic closure. You've got writing space here behind this beautiful picture. This is picture from Prague. This is, oh, I can't say it in English. I don't remember. It's Prašná brána. I can't, dusty something. Dusty gate, probably. I have no idea how to say that in English. But it's from Prague. I'm from vintage Prague. If someone Czech person just hit me, I think they will laugh in so hard how I translate it. Here I've got two small tags. You know, Prague is very vintage, very old, not vintage, very old, beautiful city, really romantic city. It's something like Paris. Paris is much more better probably because there is that Eiffel Tower, but we've got beautiful, beautiful places in Prague as well. So here another those writing pages. Oh, this video will be too long. Here we've got, it's holding so well because those magnets are very strong. Here is like window pocket. Window pocket. Here a few tags and some ephemeras. Yeah, go there. Okay, I will place it later. And it's holding on this one. Again, pages for writing. Here we've got pocket with those ephemeras. Oh, this is cabinet card, this cabinet card. And this ephemera, I will put it there later. Here I've got small tag, and here I used my stamps. This is, I think, Inka Dinka. Inka stamp, and this is the Tim Holtz stamps. Here I've got this beautiful, this is postcard, and I made it like a pocket. So we've got here this writing space, and it's pocket here. When you turn it, we've got layout from dice here, and here I've got, this is from keychain. And I've got here this beautiful cabinet card and this ephemera. And I think I've got a bunch of ephemeras which will go with this journal as well. Somewhere I have to find it. Here is pocket using that glossing bag. And I decorated that glossing bag with this ephemera. And I've got there this embossed tag. And here is small mini booklet, like a grungy mini booklet. With pockets, with pages. Here are some pockets. Some paper doily numbers. It's very small, teeny mini booklet. This is actually negative from my dies. And it looks really good intact. And I've got also that the die here somewhere where I've got it. Here. Oh, no. Okay, here's 2, 3. Start. And here, just small ephemeras. So this is my grungy journal. All these journals will be for sale. I will put links down below. I think this video it's very long already. So thank you so very much for watching. I hope you found some inspiration. These other journals I will share in another video with hopefully some tutorial or sharing as well. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you so much for all your amazing comments. You are so kind to me. I do appreciate that so much. I'm sorry for that delay with this, but you know, virus, it's virus. It got me so well. So thank you so very much for watching, for all your amazing comment. If you didn't subscribe yet, please do it. I hope I will always bring some inspiration or some good ideas to you. Have a great day. Take care about yourself and see you next time. Bye.